Hello students, welcome to the online tutorial session. In the previous lecture session, we have learned that how we will do binary addition and the subtraction. Today we will learn about the binary addition and the subtraction rule in case of octal number system. Okay, so let me take the question first. In your book, in exercise number 6-3, one question is given, that is 4, 5, 3. Base 8, I have to add 3, 1, 2 base 8. Okay. This sum is very simple. It's not complicated. That's why I'm not explaining too much the rule. Just write it down. Normal decimal addition we are doing the same thing. So it is 3 plus 2, 5. Okay, 5 plus 1 it is 6, and 4 plus 3 is 7. So all the digits, okay, 7, 6, 5, all the digits are present in this octal number system. That's why we don't need to change it any other number system, because octal number system consisting the digit 0 to 7. So whatever digit in the answer part we are getting, that is under this octal number system. So that's why we don't need to convert it. But if you take another example that is given in your book, that is 5567 base 8 plus 4025 base 8. Okay, so after addition you will see that the addition, the sum part is exceeding the digit, that is this not belongs to the octal number system. For this reason we have to build a table. Okay, I am first showing you the table, what are the rows and columns, then in the smaller version I will draw it. It is, you will write here as a decimal, it is the octal number system, then you write down quotient slash carry, remainder slash sum. Okay, in this way we will write down. Okay, in this way we will prepare this chart. Okay, chart is clear. So again, if we have to write down, so 7, if you try to add 7 with 5, okay, so 7 plus 5 you write down over here, 7 plus 5, so answer is what? Okay, I'm erasing that one, I'm showing you the table, and then otherwise it will be difficult for you to understand. Let me first place this number. So 7 plus 5, it is 12. So 12 is not, doesn't comes under the octal number system. For this reason, in the decimal part, the table we have made, decimal part, octal part, remainder sum, carry part, I am only writing D O R slash it is C, and it is R slash it is remainder, Q slash C, and R slash S. Okay, so 7 plus 5 it is 12, right? 7 plus 5 it is 12. So if you are dividing, we need to in octal, again we are doing the addition in decimal number system, 12. So 12 is not a part of a octal number system. So what you have to do, we have to divide 12 by 8. If we divide 12 by 8, then what is the quotient value we are getting? Quotient we are getting 1, okay, quotient we are getting 1, and remainder, 12 minus 8, remainder we are getting, it is 4. So what is in the remainder part, that will goes in the sum part, that is here we are written 4, and quotient part which is 1, that will be goes for a carry part. Okay, so next, for this is the next, add 1 plus 6, it is 7, 7 plus 2 it is 8, 7 plus 2 it is 9. So again we have to do, you have to clear this out, so it become 1 plus 6 plus 2, that is 9. So 9 divided by 8, so quotient is 1 and remainder is also 1. So we have put over here 1, remainder part will goes to the sum part and the quotient part will taken as a carry part. So 5 plus 1 it is 6. Okay, done. So again it is 5 plus 4. 5 plus 4 it is 9. Okay, so 9 I am writing over here. 5 plus 4. So 5 plus 4 is 9. If you divide 9 by 8, the quotient is 1, carry is 1. Sum part I am writing over here and carry part is there, carry 1 is there. But no other digit is there. So we will put down the carry. So in this way, we have to do the sum. Okay. Next, another sum we are doing. Okay, I hope it is clear. So next, another sum we are taking. So suppose it is written 162 base 8 plus 537 base 8. Okay, so 162 it is 537. 7 plus 2 9. Okay, so this is D octal. This is D, it is octal, it is quotient plus carry, it is remainder slash sum. So 2 plus 7, it is 9. So 9 divided by 8, so quotient is 1, carry is also. Quotient is 1 and the sum, remainder is also 1. So 1, 1 and here carry is 1. So 6 plus 1 is 7, 7 plus 3 is 10. So it is 1 plus 6 plus 3. So answer is 10. So here 10 divided by 8. So if you 10 divided by 8, quotient part will be 1 and remainder part will be 2. So remainder is goes to the sum part. So 2 is over here and quotient is 1. So 5, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 5, it's 7. So 7, 2, 1, basic. In this way, we have to perform the addition rule. Okay, so now we are moving to the next part, that is the octal subtraction. This is up to done the octal addition. So for octal subtraction, is the rule is something that is different. So what is actually the rule? Okay, so I am taking a smaller example at first. Okay. So right now I'm taking the example, that is 4, 5, 6 base 8, you need to subtract 1, 7, 3 base 8. Okay, so we are writing this one 4, 5, 6 and 1, 7, 3. Normal subtraction first we are doing 6 minus 3, so answer is 3. Very good. But we cannot subtract. We cannot subtract 7 from 5. So for this reason, we have to take borrow. As it is an octal number system, we will take borrow 8. Okay, so 8. So 8 plus 5, this becomes what? 13. Now from 13, I will subtract 7. So from 13, I will subtract 7. What will be the value? The value will be 6. So I am writing 6 over here. As we have taken borrow, so I have to subtract 1 from the next digit. So I am subtracting 1 from this next digit. So 4 become 3. So 3 minus 1 it is 2, all in base 8. Okay, it's a small example. Now we are taking another example. Okay, another example from your book. It's a bigger one. At least I am taking this 50 3, 4, 5 base 8 minus 2, 1, 4, 2, 6 base 8. Okay, so we are writing 50 3, 4, 5 and 6, 2, 4, 1, 2. So 5 minus 6 cannot possible, so that's why we have taken 8. So 8 plus 5, again it is 13. 13 minus 6, answer is 7. Okay, so I am writing 7. As we have taken borrow from here, so we have to subtract and make it 3. 3 minus 2, answer is 1. So again 3 minus 4, that cannot be possible, we have to add 8. So if you add 8 with 3, so answer become what? 11. So 11 minus 4. 11 minus 4, answer is what? Answer is 7. As we have done what? As we have done, taken a borrow from here, so I have to deduct something from here. Okay, so the thing is that here to only 0 is there. So how can we do? So previously I have to deduct here from 1 and give this 8 over here. Okay, then from the 8 I am deducting 1, so it becomes 7. Okay, again I am repeating. So 7 minus 1, it becomes 6. Okay, again I am repeating this step. So here we have add 8 plus 3, that is 11. 11 minus 4, that is 7. So as in this part I have taken a borrow, so I have to deduct 1 from the next digit, but in the next digit is 0, so we cannot deduct. So for this reason I have to add 8. As in this digit I have added 8, I am taking a borrow. From the next digit I have to subtract. So from the next digit I have subtracted 1, and here it becomes 8. So now from 8 I have to subtract 1, because from this digit I have taken the borrow. So it becomes 7. So 7 minus 1, it is 6. So 1 minus 8. Okay. So okay. So if we had subtract 1, here I am written 4. Here I am written my subtracting 1, so become 4. So 4 minus 2, it is 2. So 2, 2, 6, 1, 7, base 8. Okay. Another sum is also there. I hope it is clear. So we were moving to the next sum, that is 5405 base 8 minus 77 base 8. Very good. So writing 5405 and 77, those positions are blank. In this position we will write down 0. So 5 minus 7 cannot possible, that's why we have taken 8. So 8 plus 5, it is 13. Again 13 minus 7 becomes 6. So 6. Here is also 0, that cannot be possible. I have to take a borrow. So here I have taken 8. So 8 plus 0 becomes 8. As from here I have taken a borrow, so I need to deduct 1 from here also, 7. So 7 minus 7, it becomes 0. 3 minus 0, so answer is 3, and 5 minus 0, answer is 5. Okay, so the final answer is 5306. So in this way you have to perform the octal addition and the octal subtraction. I hope this concept is clear to you. If you have any doubt, so in the comment section please comment. Okay, so thank you student, I'm ending my lecture over here.